Hey, welcome to the stream. It's the 306th day, making Songbringer. And today, I'm going to draw the sword in detail for this new cutscene. So, I've always wanted this cutscene when you pick up the sword to be cooler. Like, I always imagine more lightning coming down or light or something. And also, I wanted to zoom in, like, really, really close on this sword. So I'm going to do, today's stream is going to be, I'm going to be drawing this sword in detail. Like, I'm going to do a 400 pixel wide, like, really close-up shot on this sword. What's up, Hardboiled? Pedro! Pizza! Oh, Pizza, you got to see this. What's up, Salad Dongs? Sounds not working. Hold on, my sound's not working. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot more too. There's gonna be music playing in the background. So on this screen right here, you're gonna hear like some thumping background music as if it were in some club right next door. And then when you go down to this scene down here, this is where there's just going to be a huge party going on. There's going to be like a DJ booth in the middle. There's probably going to be like a drum set up here. Just tons of people partying down there and like dancing, basically. Dance, like a dance or slash rock concert almost. You're welcome, Pizza. Your favorite is the laughing guy? Yeah, this guy's awesome, right? Yeah. What's up, Arcane? Yeah, mustache guy. So there'll be so many more characters to draw. But so today I'm gonna work on the sword though. Might as well leave that for a moment. What's up, Chaos Gaming? All right. So what I need to establish first is how big I want this to be. I'm thinking it's like two screens high. So if we had that much, that's like 380 pixels or something. So if this were 380 pixels, multiply that by 380 times 1.75, is that right? 665, that's not right. Yeah, the mustache, right? The Dr. Robotnik guy? What's up, Zanger? Here you go, I'm making textures for this map portion. Oh, cool. No worries, Chaos. Oh, sorry, man. Well, yeah, dude, you don't have to stick around if you want to go do your own stream, of course. What's up, Woogie? I'm trying to think of how many pixels this needs to be. This is 380. If it were half. Yeah, 380 times a half times 1.75 would be 332. 380 by 332. Close enough. Whoops. So how you guys doing? Songbringer t-shirts? Yeah, I'm wearing one right now. Songbringer t-shirt. Yep, I got these and stickers. That's going to be at the event on February 18th at the Microsoft Reactor Center or whatever at the here in San Francisco. What? The stream's already dead? No, what? Oh my god. Oh. Dude, really? The internet's got that bad here? I'm already streaming at the lowest rate I can possibly get away with. Oh my god. So lame. Well, you can still hear, huh? This is what I did yesterday. What's up, White Rice? I was like, okay, I'll just describe everything, but that's just lame, right? I mean, yeah, you can hear me. Well, I'll keep streaming. I mean, I hope it gets better, but dude, I need to have another phone conversation with my Comcast. This sucks. Copy merged. I'll just crop this image, crop. Well, what I'm doing is I'm just getting the right size for this sword. And why not stream on YouTube? I mean, I could try YouTube, but the only problem with YouTube, I mean, is that it's not really the problem with YouTube, but it's just that my internet, I'm pretty sure the problem is my internet, not Twitch. Nice, Pedro. Good job, man. Yeah. Right on, man. Sounds like you're getting faster. With no gimbal lock. Right on. Yeah, maybe. I mean, I could try another service. Yeah, I guess it's probably worth a try then, huh? This is kind of getting ridiculous. Phooey, pooey. Quaternion's got him. Done. Check. You're making a platformer, Zyger? Right on. So this needs to be 5 pixels taller. Pasted the wrong one. Chaos Gaming, am I recruiting mods? Not at the moment. We've got so many mods. Yeah, there you go. 14 days to get your art done. Cool, man. I'm gonna have to start firing mods. What's up, Sam's number one fan? Yeah, it's not just you. I think it's my internet. It's like super weak sauce. I got my stream set to only output 1,000 kilobits per second. So I'm only uploading a meg per second, and it can't do that anymore. It's like my upload speed for my internet is just shot. It's like completely crap. Either that, or I'm just having a horrible connection with Twitch, and they're just having the busiest day ever. What am I doing with the cutscene? This cutscene is for when you pick up the sword, and it's gonna zoom in on the sword, basically. Yeah, I've done like so many speed tests like every single day, and our download speeds are great. Our upload speeds are shit. Like literally less than 5 megs a second, and apparently it's less than that today because of this. Either that or Twitch is having troubles. I don't know. Yeah, Chaos, it's not going to help to restart the stream. It's the same thing, the exact same thing happened yesterday. So it's not the stream. That's why it's either the internet or Twitch. Okay, so my next task is to turn this into a giant drawing instead of a tiny little pixel drawing. I know you guys can't see this, but at least you'll be able to see it on YouTube later. So I'm going to get some inspiration. Yours is less than 5 on a good day? Whoa. 1.5 up on a good day? Dude, it's crazy. Yeah, for me, like I used to have like 15 up. It was great because we're paying for this upgraded internet. And then yeah, all of a sudden, they just like, I think they did something on their end where they just stopped allowing that kind of quality. It's stupid. And then I looked on their website and you can't even tell what your upload speed is supposed to be. They only tell you what your download speed is supposed to be. So I think they did something nefarious on their end. The audio sounds better than ever. Right on. Yeah. Videos in and out. So I'm looking at Chinese swords right now. This one's pretty cool. I know they probably hate streamers. Seriously. That's what I'm thinking. It's like there's lots of more people that are doing streams today than there was a year ago. So I'm pretty sure they just like killed people's internet speeds on purpose, or their upload speeds. But this could just be all hearsay. I don't know. No, he's talking about Comcast, not Twitch. Yeah, this sword's pretty sweet. So, the nano sword for this game, I've always wanted it to be an actual nano, like it actually has nanites in it. It actually has nano technology built in. So, this zoom in on the sword is going to show some really cool stuff. Basically, when you pick up the sword, you can press a button on its handle to sheath it and unsheath it. So it has this built-in sheath, and it can get a little bit longer and a little bit shorter. So that's what this cutscene is gonna show. I just love Chinese swords. They're so cool. Well, yours caps at a limit. Yeah, see, I'm not even, I checked for sure. And I'm not over the limit. for my internet. So it's not that. It's like they just seriously just limited people. Even people like me that are paying for premium internet, which is stupid. Right? All right, so let me start with the background. Oh, wait. This whole thing needs to be 420 pixels now. Hey, what's up, PETA? I know, Google Fiber. We need Google Fiber. All right, I think I want to make this bigger, actually. So instead of being 385, it needs to go from 240. Wait. 315 divided by 240, multiply that by 380, 498, that's really tall. That's way too tall. Let's do 400. That's even too tall. Chaos. Hey man, these people really earned it. These guys that are mods, they've really been around a long time and they've been helping out, doing really cool stuff. So just if you want to be a mod, you really have to hang out longer and be more, you know, be more part of it all, and you'll earn it. All right. So yeah, if you want to be a mod, you got to earn it. All right. Yeah, this proportion will do, I guess. Okay, let's get this one out. I can start drawing on a new layer. Oh, wait, first, make this 420 by 491. Make it 420 by 490 now. All right, so I'm just taking, I know you guys probably can't even see the stream, but I'm still drawing, I'm laying down the foundation, the background for this sword. Manic, what's up? Hey, thanks for hosting. So I finally got the sword outline drawn. All right, see you, Chaos. Super Lemon Haze Cream. Beautiful name. So I'm at the point now where I'm like just blocking in random shapes rather than trying to do it all exact and awesome. I love this Chinese sword, it's so cool. It's a really cool end for one, too. So I'm taking some reference images from these Chinese swords. I'm going to use these to draw with, to reference while I draw. Sorry about the black screen, guys. Stream's not working today. My internet's either crap or Twitch is twitchy. Not sure. So what I'm doing is I'm taking some Chinese swords and I'm using them as reference images. I'm throwing them into the pixel art I've got right here so I can kind of get some good outlines drawn and then also be inspired to draw a cool sword. Play some licks on my guitar. All right. Well, back to art. Gotta get this game done. Best pixel art stream ever with no video. Right? This is so ironic. I come out here to the computer to stream with you guys, to share with you guys some pixel art. And all you can do is hear. Because God knows why. Keep putting me on full screen. Yeah, my game show is just sitting there trying to reconnect. Oh, now it's not even connected. I tried to forcibly reconnect it. Might help for a minute, but it's probably going to go back out in a second. What can happen will happen, right? Take that down. So I'm taking these reference images and I'm just throwing them into my image I'm drawing. It's back for a minute. It's back for a minute, but don't count on it being here for long, I'm telling you. You broke it. Good morning. What's up, Red Sands? What's up, Robo Dude? If you guys can still see, I got these little Chinese swords and stuff. I'm throwing them in my image as a reference, so when I draw this sword in real detail, I can draw it like as cool as I'm imagining. I love Chinese swords. They're so cool. They're my favorite kind of sword. Sword. Yep, this is a sword cutscene. This is going to be a zoomed-in, detailed sword scene. Leave it just like this. All right, Boogie. Yeah, totally. This texture on the metal here is pretty cool, right? Yeah, oh, you can actually see the t-shirt. Yeah, I'm wearing the this is the Songbringer shirt here. All right. So this first layer here, this is just crazy. Okay, I think I'm gonna start with the hilt or the blade. The blade's actually pretty easy, huh? Let's do the blade first. I'll do the blade because that's just like, should be easier. I'm gonna take my reference image, put it right about in place. And I'm gonna draw using these colors. Let's get some colors, some good colors. You can see the stream. Salad dogs. No, that was not a Kickstarter thing. That was just a thing I did last month or December, whenever December was. It was a shirt I made for the Indie Cup. Yeah, so I got two shirts, but I can make more. If you guys want to buy shirts, I can put them for sale. Thanks for the merge and then proper fix. Oh, right, for Valtry. Yeah. Nice, man. It worked. That's cool. I'm glad. Okay, so I'm grabbing a palette now, making just a quick palette of colors I can use. For the sword. That's all the sword's colors, really, right there. Okay, so I got these colors. Whoops. Oh, turn off auto select so bad. Such a bad thing. It's good for some things. You totally buy the shirt? Sweet. Oh, the shirt, yeah, it's like a long sleeve shirt. It says Songbringer. That's it. I also got posters. You guys haven't seen the posters. There's posters. These are from the Kickstarter. But I can do another poster, I guess, and sell these. What I'm really thinking would be the coolest, though, is when the game is about out, it'd be sweet to do a cloth map. Like, somebody suggested that during the Kickstarter. I forget who suggested it, but it's such a great suggestion to do a cloth map of, like, one of the worlds. So there'll be some kind of world seed where it's just like everybody knows that world seed, you know? Starting with the tip of the sword here. Poopy, it's gotta be poopy or no beer. Yeah, I should get a merch site, right? Cloth map would be cool. Gives me flashbacks to the map of Zelda 1, right? That's the point, right? You want a Songbringer flag? A jib plushie? Your family Zelda map had notes written all over it? Oh, that's so cool. Oh man, if you dude, do you if you still had that, that would be the coolest thing to like find. Find your old family's Zelda map. It'd be like finding a real treasure map. Like, wow, what is this? Is the video still going? I guess it is, huh? Maybe it was just having a little hiccup. Yes, so much nostalgia, right? Cool. Wow, I'm so glad the video is still going. This is unexpectedly awesome. So this scene here, once I finish the sword, this the first drawing of the sword statically, it's actually the finished version of this cutscene will have animation. So it's going to show how the nano sword can sheath and unsheath itself, and also how it like grows in size a tiny bit. You guys will see what I'm talking about when once we get there. The mustache could have a magnet. You could decide to put it on or not, Chips plushie. Will the game have a modding scene? Hopefully, yeah. It's gonna be moddable. So now I'm doing the second half of the sword. All right, now for the hilt. I'm just doing outline shapes at first, and then I'll go in and add some more detail and make it super awesome at the end. So there's my one of my reference images right there. Let's get this other reference image up for the handle, the hilt. See, that's just too sh this the image is too short now, so I need more height. More height. Trying to write songs on Twitch? Why not? So this is gonna need about like that much more. At least needs to be like that much taller, 72 pixels or so. So what we got here? Four. Let's go 560. All right. Let's fill this background in. Yeah. Now we got a more balanced drawing here. And I can proceed to draw cool hilt. It's not gonna be quite as long as this hilt because I think this angle is a little different. Actually, I know it's a lot different, yeah. But let's grab the palette too. Nickelback. Video's gone again. I could try and reset it again. Looks like it reset once more. Maybe I'll just keep doing that, huh? It's like it works for a minute and then it dies. What kind of internet problem would do that? Huh. I don't know, man. I don't know. So this is about 22 pixels. This is 20. That's big. What, did it go again? Nah, I went again already. Told ya. Man, I can't even fix it. Well, you know, I'm just gonna keep streaming and try and ignore the fact that the internet's not working again. And just try and do the best I can on the art here. And this will all be on YouTube later. Or the VOD. On Twitch, whatever you guys prefer. Yeah, so sorry I'm being quiet because I know you guys can only hear the stream, but just, I guess I'm in the zone over here making art. Okay, so it needs to be a little more 3D and stuff, but yeah, I guess I can make it 3D really quick. So if I add just a tiny bit of deeper color to this palette, a little more saturated. A little more hue darkening. Add this to the palette. And then I can make this hilt a little bit 3D. Sorry, yeah, I was being silent. I Okay, a little more. I'm in the zone. Okay, not bad for first draft. It's got everything kind of outlined at this point. I'm thinking next, there's going to be two modes to the sword. So one mode it's like in, one mode it's out. So I'm going to play around with that a little bit. Just outlining. We're working on like really, just working on more of shapes right now than anything. Drawing and speak to, yes, drawing and coding don't mix either. It's so hard. Danger zone. Yes, I get the reference, Bob Marley, extra crispy. Gotcha. Gotcha, man. Okay, I'm going to play around. I'm going to experiment with different shapes and proportions now. Okay, I'm thinking it's gonna have a mode where it goes and it sheaths itself. It's a nano sword, so it can like do cool stuff like that. So when it sheaths itself, it's going to get shorter. So like it's easier to fit on your back. Free parking. Yes. Free parking. I wish Boogie was here right now. He could see the, could see that. Yeah, so here's like the short sword version. It gets all sheathed up. Hey, Boogie is here! Did you see the free parking? Oh. That's so cool, though, that he, that just the fact that he does give free parking. All right, now I'm gonna experiment with the, well, I think this, yeah. Need to adjust a little bit. The bigger sword actually has a smaller sheath. Songbringer for Atari? Who could forget about Atari? Or NES. The ZX Spectrum. Yes. Only cyan, magenta, red, and yellow. Commodore 64. For the win. Commodore, dude. Commodore was such a great system. Game Boy, for sure. All right, now that I've got this, I got the hilt slim slightly. Same thing with the sword. So when it sheaths, it can be way more sheathed up. But I do want to play. I want to play with making the hilt different. So I'm gonna try a differently shaped hilt. Something more kind of what I was imagining that this thing would look like. More square, less of these lines. Huh. Yeah, I think I did like the other one better. It's good to have them all out here, though. Summer Connect. You hate squares in your pixel art. All right, I'm going to draw a sheath over the top of this small one now. Oh, actually, I need to get a hilt color. Let's merge all these layers now. Okay, so let me turn the palette on. I'm going to add something to the palette. Like a darker color over in this range. It's a bit too dark though. You prefer to have a game development? That way I can actually find some game devs. Right now you're in the same section as a body painter. Really? I thought game dev was a hashtag though. I thought you could actually sort by hashtag. Yeah. Yeah. So now I'm darkening half the hilt. I accidentally drew the wrong opacity. Okay, I'm adding a different sheath layer. Whoops. Nice, Rubber Ninja, it's a cool name. Boogie, oh, you can actually see the stream? All right, pizza, see you, man. Hopefully this stream is better tomorrow. Oh, look, it is working. Yeah, so I'm just playing around with overall shapes right now and what happens when the sword sheaths itself and stuff. Later, brah. It is back. So what I'm deciding right now whether to keep this the squarier version on the right or the more not squarier version in the middle. You like the curved hilt? Yeah, I like it better too so far. The square one is like a bit too square. Yeah. Okay. Let's ditch this other one. Middle two? Nice. Right on. Middle it is. All right, well, I'm just going to detail the heck out of this one now, then. Yeah, of course, man. Link, please. Link, link, link. Link away. Link it while you got it. I'm thinking I might experiment with a different color palette here. Like this. And that. And yeah, Darkest Dungeon. I love their comic art. It's cool. Yeah. It's 48 degrees? What? So I'm drawing a little highlight on the edge. Complex number points. I forgot what a complex number even is. It's been that long since I've taken any math. Yeah, 88 points. Here you go. Man, it's so cool that Boogie made Bob Fu. We have this crazy game we can play now. Get each other points. Trying to win stuff. Ah, there we go. Now it's starting to look a little better. Back to the Future! You can go back in time? Really? How do you do that? Sounds awesome. So can I go back in time and with my disgraced nuclear physicist friend and try to kiss my own mother? What is this, Back to the Future? Yes, that's the plot to Back to the Future. Yep. It's basically how it goes. Oh yeah, this is for a cutscene. Yeah, yep. When he gets the sword. You need a flux capacitor, plutonium, it's all you need. Yep, you can find all those things in the grocery store. Every disgraced nuclear physicist knows this. Okay, so now some shading for the other side of the sword. I'll probably eventually throw a texture on top of this all too to give it a little bit more, you know, textury feeling. It's a 2 hour Mac from the last time I restarted. If only it worked that way. I've actually been streaming for an hour and a half. Hour and 22 minutes, to be exact. Oh no. Oh there. Phew. Phew. You just want to go to bed? Go to bed, man. You don't have to stay. Oh no, sorry, you were actually using the long stream command. Oh. It. What's Bot Fu up to today? I wonder how Bot's food day was. How was your day, Bot Fu? Blap blap blap. Oh man, we're gonna have the funniest long stream messages. All right, so now that I've kind of got this the blade sort of drawn, I'm gonna go and try a texture. I'm gonna grab the middle of this sword. Let's see what I can do about using this as a texture. There. Okay, now I got a texture. I can repeat. I'm gonna make it, should be as big as the whole sword. I'm just making it repeatable. There we go. Now I got a texture all repeated. Onboard Metal Gear Ray. Video's back again. All right, there. So now I got that. I can apply this only to that layer and then make it really. Yeah. Just barely see it. That's what I'm talking about. Cool. That looks sweet. What would it look like with more? No, that's right. It's good right there. 15%. Great. Maybe 16. Okay. Next for the hilt. Start working on the hilt. Wow, the video's been working for 10 minutes. Mod votes count as 100. It froze again. Of course it did. All right, for my other inspiration, this is the other Chinese hilt I really liked. Where'd it go? There it is. That's why we need complex numbers. It's up to 52. That's up 4 degrees warmer. Should be noticeable. What's up, PMC? What's up, Lime? How you doing, guys? The video is probably out. The video is getting it going in and out today. It might be on. I don't know. If you guys can see it, then yay. But if you can't, I'm working on a Chinese sword look for the... It's a zoomed in version of the sword when you pick up the sword for the first time. So I'm doing the detail work on the hilt right now. You were banned from talking yesterday? It must have been one of these mods gone crazy on you. That's weird. Sorry about that. You can always message me and I'll try and unban you or what's the other thing that's not banned but it makes you quiet for a minute? Refresh confirmed. So, how you guys doing? Just join. What's up, Azarus? Twitch banned you? That's weird. Probably Boogie's fault, though. Linear algebra homework. You were banned from streaming because I told people they were using ViewBots, and they really were? What? Really? You said C++ is greater than C sharp and he banned you? Oh my God, that's crazy. Oh no, somebody ban Hard-Boiled Egg and then unban him? Yeah. I know. I like C sharp too. I mean, I haven't really used it. But yeah, I would never ban someone for saying that. It's crazy. Ah, that's what it needed. Yeah, this is making it look 3D. There we go. Yeah. Not there, not there, not there. Undo, undo. Yeah, sorry, there's no video today, guys. It's going in and out. I don't know what the problem is. It's either Twitch or it's Comcast. So, rather than just not even stream, I'm streaming anyways. Sometimes you'll have audio. Sometimes the video will come back in and you'll be able to see a little bit of what's being worked on this sword. That's pretty good. Metal. It's a silent podcast. That's all it is. You guys don't like silent podcasts? What's with that? Describe the image to us in detail. Well, okay, at pixel 241, 238, we have the color red 215, green 211, and blue 207. In hexadecimal, that's D7, D3, CF, everybody. All right, you ready for the next pixel? I think you need to get Comcast to send one out. Yeah. Yeah, Solid Dongs, they probably do, huh? I mean, that's when I called them last time, they said we could do this. Would you like us to? And I'm like, no, I'll just try and get the better box first or whatever. So I did get a better box, but then nothing happened after that. So, I mean, it never got better. So, yeah, I should probably call them, just have them come out, schedule that up, because seriously, this is hurting. This is hurting everything. You hired to be tech support? They only cared about sales? Oh no, man. Thanks, Boogie. Probably something wrong with the line leading up to your house. But yeah, it could be, huh, Salad Dongs? Maybe it is. You know, I need to call him at least on the phone and confirm what my upload rate is supposed to be as well. Because, I mean, it was a solid 15 for a long, long time. And that was why I could stream at such good quality. I could give you guys, like, my whole screen. But, yeah, it's just been horrible internet since then. The thing is, I still have great download rates, though. That's what makes me think that it's not something on my end. But, I mean, it could be. Is it possible for your cable to be messed up? It is cable internet, so if it's possible for cable internet to be messed up on the upload but not the download, then that's the problem I have. Okay, now I'm gonna do some like etch work and stuff. Hold on. I'm trying to decide whether I should make these edges of this thing taper inward. Yeah, that would be kind of cool, huh? What's up, Stadoff Games? Yeah, you guys have Shaw and Telus, and they both suck? Yeah. Yeah, you're right, Salad Dongs. Yeah. And you never know, right? You never know. And at least if I get somebody to come out here and take a look at the internet, then I can scratch that off the list, you know, like, okay, somebody came and checked it out. Okay, I am gonna try and taper this. See what this looks like tapered. Yeah, that's kind of cool, but it needs less tapering right there and more tapering right here. So this needs to go like... There's also a possibility that your node is poorly managed and someone is on it using a lot of bandwidth. Could be, but that you would think that was me, that was my responsibility. I'm pretty sure I'm the only one around this neighborhood that would be streaming, but I don't know. You never know. They could be tampering with my connection, right? It's called a sales tactic. Really? Yeah, Johnny Boy, I would believe that. I would believe that somebody at Comcast is like doing it to try and get me to upgrade. They do call all the time. They're like, hey, wouldn't you like a better internet package? I'm like, I already bought the internet, the better internet package. The half year you spent unemployed was way better than working there. I hear you. Oh yeah, this is cool. It's more Chinesey. Steam requires so much info for the game's page, right, Lime? Oh my God, yeah. The first time I went and filled out the Steam page, I was like, oh my God, this is giving me a headache. Steam is like really gigantic and huge and confusing, but once you filled it out once, it's good, because then you're all set up and you really only need to go in and make minor touches later. Nodes can cover a pretty wide area. All it takes for someone with the highest tier plans running BitTorrent and uploading constantly, combined with the node not being afforded enough bandwidth. Yeah. That could be it. Maybe somebody moved into our neighborhood recently or something and is just using it all. They oversell bandwidth since people download in chunks and not all at once. Upload speed is the bandwidth they pay for. Yeah. I'm paying for premium Comcast internet. It's like we pay like 70 to 80 bucks a month. So I know PMC, that's the horrible part, right? They're like, "Hey, did you try turning it off and back on? Did you try resetting your modem?" Yeah, I tried that already. In fact, I called you guys and you guys did it over the phone anyways last time. Yeah, so I kind of gave this, I gave one of these, the edges of the sword, a little bit more of a rounded look. I'm liking it. Liking it. Another trick for dealing with the cable companies is straight up threaten to cancel your service. Yeah. Yeah, I know, right? Hey, what's up, C Trampy? Do you see update downloads per day? Do I see update downloads per day? What? Oh, I know. Yeah, sorry. Sorry about the internet, guys, or I mean the stream. Sometimes it's here. Sometimes I'll try resetting it again. Really? Johnny boy. Yeah, I just reset it, so hopefully it's back for a minute. Okay, now I'm debating on which side of the hilt I like better, the square, the more angled side or the rounder side. I think I'm gonna stick with the rounder side. I like the rounder side. But what do you guys think? If you guys can see it. Happy Moose? Happy Moose, what were you saying about update downloads per day. Lime likes a rounded too. Cool. I'm liking his rounded look. Your dad gets 50 megs of internet from Shaw, but our monarch only gives us 2.5. What? Oh man. Thanks, Arbold. It's getting there. It's getting there. So now I'm gonna start doing some detail work on here. What's that? Oh, I was asking about the sides of the sword. Which one you guys like better? This side, the left, or the right? I think I'm going to stick with this right side, though. At least I'll try experimenting with it first. Yeah, I know. Definitely needs to be more competition in the ISP business. Hardboard likes the right side. Okay. Good to know. Left one for cutscene, but yeah, the right one probably fits more. Well, I could probably do both. What's the time of the actual stream? The actual stream's at 1:50. Oh, the internet went out already. Let me try resetting it one more time. I mean, it's supposed to reconnect on its own. There we go. They mostly buy from CenturyLink? That's so funny. I know. Sorry, guys. I just tried resetting it like 3 times. Let's hope Comcast gets a new CEO. What is, oh my God, Steve Tranby, it's so awesome. It's back again. Oh, it's back again. In and out. It's back. What? It's back for a minute. Let's see how long it can be back for. All right. We're back. I know, it should be the norm. Why isn't it the norm? Yep, working on the hilt, getting some detail in on this hilt. I might try and detail out both sides of the hilt just to make it, I don't know, experiment with both of them, see which one. Free parking! It's rigged. Yeah, I'm liking this. This is looking good. Maybe Google Fire will start getting serious, please. Yeah. You hate Wiley Plus? Wiley Plus? What's Wiley Plus? Horrible program my school makes me pay for and use? What? Is it for math or something? Education software? Oh. Ugh. Yeah, that is. I know. Google can't just have all the right everything. Haven't we learned our lesson about monopolies? Doop doo ah. 2 hour notice. Thanks, Pedro. You trust Google with your soul? Yeah, I don't know. I'm right. I use Google. I love Google. Everything about Google's pretty cool. But it's like, it's still worry about that sometimes. Like, really? These guys can't, you know, once one company has it all, you know. Maybe I'm just worried for no reason. Google is what we should worry about its alphabet. Oh, we're getting raided. What's up, raiders? Can you raiders actually see what's going on? Maybe you can. What's up, raiders? Where are you from? What stream are you raiding in from? It must be quasitive. Quasitive. What's up, Quasitive? Quasitive, hello. Welcome to the stream, Quasitive. I'm drawing a sword for this cutscene for this game. What's up? Welcome, people. Maybe if while you're here, I'll show you what this game looks like. Raid! Raid! Is the screen frozen again? Hopefully the screen is not frozen in a second here. No video again? Let me turn it off. I'll turn it off and turn it back on. Maybe it works again. Is it working again? Hopefully it's working again. This game is called Songbringer. Oh, look, he's wearing a shirt right now. Oh, he's wearing a shirt because I don't have a sword. This is what this game is, though. It's like Zelda. All I have is the top hat. Crazy! We got bugs because we're on the fun branch. Yeah, he's got a shirt on right there. I don't know if this is gonna work or whatever, but let me get back to the zero and I'll show you what I'm working on. He does have a shirt on. He actually does have a shirt sometimes. But he normally doesn't because he crashed your. This is like Zelda 1. This game is like Zelda 1, right? You slide from screen to screen just like this. You have this little friend. His name is Jib. He's a little robot that follows you around. He's your helpmate. He's like your friend. He scans the bodies of enemies when you kill them. A shirt and no sword. So, yeah, this game's been in development for over a year now, and it's coming out this year. Thanks. Thanks, Nopo Kiwi. Oh, there's no sound this time? Dude, this stream has been so weird today. Sorry, I wish you guys could hear this. There's like lots going on audio-wise. But yeah, this is kind of what this game is like. Do you make those dynamic shadows? They're just 2D shadows. You can't have everything. They're just 2D shadows, man. So I take the same sprite that I draw the game with. So for example, the hero, the main hero, just take his sprite and then make it black, flip it over, make it a little bit transparent, and then set it at a skew angle. That's really all there is to those shadows. Oh, see you, Lime. Yeah, sorry about the mess up stream today. I know, bad time to get raided. But yeah, that's what this game's like. Sorry about the sound, sorry about the video. But basically I'm drawing this sword, a detailed sword for the this cutscene. All right. So I've kind of got one side of this hilt drawn. Actually I'll do a little bit more on this right here. Do some etching. Sorry about the once again, sorry about the stream because today I've had the craziest internet problems. So it's probably gonna go out here any second now. But I am about finished with my stream anyway. So I usually stream for about 2 hours a day making this game. And yep, I'm at about 2 hours anyways, so I'll probably be shutting the stream down in like the next 5 minutes. All right, that's pretty good. Oh, you developed the game called Skyhook? Cool. What's up, Skyhookers? Skyhookers. What's Skyhook? While you're finding a solution for that maze? Yes. Megastorm! Cool name. Whoa, cool. Nice. Everybody's got all these grappling hooks. Whoa, the shark guy can like. Yeah, the shark character is awesome. Nice. How's early access working out for you guys? Hook smash. Mustache guy. Yeah, of course, man. It's cool to know. So what's so you stream under your name there, Quasitive. How often you guys stream, and how long you guys been developing that game and all that? Oh, it's been rough? Rough developing, or you mean early access has been rough? Oh, Quasi TV. What's up, Quaz? One year, 10 months. Wow. Dang, that's a nice man. You've been developing already for 2 years. Streaming. Monday through Friday, 2 p.m. Good for you. That's awesome. Nice. Really? My Gamma Sutra article? That's cool. Wow, I'm glad I was able to. Hopefully it helped. Was it good for you or what? Follow the yellow brick road. Do it. Do it. Just do it. Well, this is an amazing stroke of luck that the stream has actually lasted this long. The internet's going in and out here for me today. So it may just go out on us randomly here. You started streaming recently. Okay. Good, dude. I'm glad it's been amazing. It's awesome. Right on. Heck yeah. I'm excited to hopefully I've been a helpful influence. And I hope the best for your game too. It looks awesome. So yeah, I've been drawing this sword all stream, and I'm just working on it to for this cutscene. There's gonna be a crazy cool cutscene where you lift the sword. Oh, you guys saw that a second ago. Yeah, where you lift the sword. Yeah, the cure for indie game failure, totally. Yeah, totally. Yeah, I definitely that's like that article there represents probably 2 years worth, no, more than 2 years. That really what's the lessons I've learned in game development over the last 5 years are all kind of summed up in that article. And really I could sum it up like this. You got to prove that your game is going to sell before you work on it. You know what I mean? If you spend all of your time developing your prototype and making your game awesome and doing all the things that are fun in game development, it's so great to make a game, right? But if you do all that expecting people to buy it and you don't know that people actually will buy it, you're in for probably a world of hurt. Because you're probably gonna get come to the point where you know, where you find out the truth where it's really hard to succeed in games. So the thing is, what you gotta do is prove that people are gonna buy your game before you go spend the years to make it, right? And then if and that's okay if you fail, because then you can just go make another game and you can make something else that people might like the next time. So you keep trying to prove that people will buy your game before you actually go and spend years to make it. So my theory is the longest you should work on a game is like a few months before you just to build a prototype, and then you can prove that people will buy it by doing by doing a Kickstarter or an Indiegogo campaign or alpha funding. There's lots of different ways to see if people will actually buy your idea before you have to go spend all the time to make it. Kickstarter is freaking amazing. It's like a godsend tool that we can use as game developers to prove whether people will to prove the game. Basically, that's what it's all about. It's about proving your game. Make sure people will buy your game before you spend forever making it. That's weird. Oh, it probably has two different articles links because I started with the first one and then changed the title the next day. Pfft, stupid of me, right? Okay, so that's what it would look like if it had either kind of hilt, sort of. I'm not gonna work too much longer on the right side of the hilt because I think I like the left side better overall. I like how the left side tapers to a point. It's really cool. Whoops. Although if I did change anything, I would probably take away a pixel there and there. Cure. Oh, nice. Yeah, Jonah, this is the nano sword. This is it. So it's gonna have a cool feature where it you can press a button on its hilt and it sheaths itself. All right, so next up, I'm gonna make the texture for the hilt part, or the handle. But I think I'm almost done with the stream because I'm already at 2 hours and 15 minutes. So I'm gonna have to take a break and get some dinner and stuff. But for the rest of the night, or not probably the whole night, but tonight I'll be doing this handle and a little bit of background, and then maybe tomorrow I'll work on this actual scene. So you'll be able so when you pick up the sword, there'll be like a zoom in sec. It's got the same animation where you're holding the sword in the air and everything, but then it'll zoom in and show this. So, yeah, so that's it for today's stream. Thank you guys for, yeah, thanks for everything. Hope you had a good time watching the black screen of death for a while. But at least this video will be on YouTube for later, so you can actually see what I was drawing while the screen was black. So, yep, see you guys next time. Peace. Peace, peace, peace.